Good afternoon all. Welcome to the class of SEM 3. Now we will be having today the DC power supply. So we'll be working on that. Right. So am I visible? I'm audible and my screen is visible clearly. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
So, good afternoon. Good afternoon to you all. Now, today we are going to start with a new topic that is called as power supplies. Yes, power supplies, you have made it in the first years. And we have tried our level best to teach you. So, still, you are not able to know about what the blocks are doing over there. But still we have tried to implement that circuit. In fact, we have think of, say, making of regulated power supply, that to dual power supply, plus 12 volt, minus 12 volt, plus 5, minus 5 volt. We have tried to design it. We have tried to implement that circuit without knowing much about that circuit. So this was very big achievement for the department itself, that the students of first year are being taught to how to design a power supply. Today we are going to start with that particular topic that is called as the DC power supply, and for that you should know or you should understand and recall the basic components that we have studied earlier, that actually we call it as the diodes and say the transistors. So you should recall those things. So we'll be starting with that. Let us start with what we are going to study in this chapter, that is actually contains half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier and bridge rectifier. We'll be covering all that, and I expect you might be knowing that we have done this. We have designed the regulated power supply of a dual regulated power supply using this bridge rectifier circuit. Now we are going to study how this bridge rectifier circuit is going to work and why is it required, right? So actually what does these rectifiers means? So remember this, rectifier. What rectifier means? A rectifier is an electrical circuit, electrical device which converts alternating current, that is AC, into DC, right? The circuit which converts AC into DC is called as a rectifier. Remember this circuit. So the rectifier, only the rectifier circuit is going to convert this AC signal into a DC signal, right? Now, first of all, let us see what is the requirement of this rectifier and where it is required actually. So we'll be having the block diagram of the DC power supply. Hopefully this is a regulated power supply block diagram, and we should understand what type of circuit it looks like. So on the block level, I'm trying to tell you that this, on the left hand side, as you are able to see, this is the plug that we are going to put in the 230 volt AC. Everybody has this, so we'll be putting that over there. What we have used, a black colored wire over there, and then it was given to a transformer. Now the central one is a transformer. The waveforms is given on the top of it. So these are the waveforms. The black color line, which is sinusoidal wave, is given over here. This is the waveform that is being shown over here. So the AC signal is having a higher voltage, so it is a little bit higher. So it is going to give you 230 volt AC with 50 hertz frequency. That is what we are having at our homes. So this is the basic block diagram that we have studied now. So when we put this plug in over here, and it is given to the primary of a transformer, then the output voltage is taken from the secondary. So the secondary has a less voltage, but still it is AC only. So remember this, transformer does not convert AC into DC. It just reduces the amplitude or increases the amplitude. Other than that, it is not doing anything. So the rectifier circuit is going to convert AC into DC, right? So transformer just converts a higher AC to lower AC, or vice versa, say a lower AC to a higher AC, depending upon the type of a transformer. So we are having two types of a transformer. One is called as step-up transformer and the other one is called as the step-down transformer. The step-down transformer gets a higher AC voltage and converts it, lowers it to a lower AC voltage. That is called as a step-down transformer. So in our circuits, I hope you might remember that we have used a step-down transformer. Now, what does the step-up transformer does? Step-up transformer increases the amplitude of the AC signal. Means if you have a lower AC, it again rises high the AC voltage, and that therefore it is called as a step-up, so increasing. So step-up transformer and step-down transformer are here. Those transformers are here. Now in this circuit, we are going to use a step-down transformer that we have used it earlier. So this was that. Then the output of this step-up step-down transformer is given to this block that is called as a rectifier. Yes. Now here we are having a rectifier. Remember, the circuit that we have used earlier is called as a rectifier, and the rectifier block is over here. So here we are going to use that circuit. That circuit might be a half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier, or a full wave bridge rectifier. So we are having three circuits we are going to study in the coming classes. So this is that block that we call it as a rectifier. Before it, the input is to this rectifier is a pure AC. It's not DC. Here also, after the rectifier's output, means the output of the rectifier is also not a pure DC. Remember this. The output of the rectifier is not a pure DC, but it is called as a pulsating DC. It is called as a pulsating DC. P-U-L-S-A-T-I-N-G. Pulsating DC. Right? So, this is that pulsating DC signal. If you are able to see, this is that waveform we are having at the output of this rectifier. Then this pulsating DC, this output is given to the filter circuit. Now in our case, we have used a 1000 microfarad capacitor over there, and which is going to filter this, and it is going to give a pure DC. So the rectifier circuit and the filter together will give you a pure DC. Before that, it is a pure AC over here. Now, again, depending on the AC input, because it is fluctuating, 230 volt AC, it is a standard norm. But it goes on varying from, say, around 240, 250 volt to, say, 170 or 180 volt. Accordingly, this transformer is going to give you the AC signal again, AC lower signal again. And echo, and on that, the rectifier is going to fluctuate the output. So the pure DC, which we are expecting over here at the output, is going to fluctuate from, say if you want 5 volt or 6 volt, then it may fluctuate from 7, 8, or they move, maybe less than that, the 4 volt it can go. So we require a voltage regulator circuit over here to regulate that at a very constant voltage. So if you want a 12 volt, then we require this to remain at 12 volt. It should not go 12.1 or 12.19, say 11.9. So for that, we require some voltage regulator ICs that we have used it in our circuits, like 78XX series and 79XX series. So we have used four ICs, positive two ICs, 7812, if you remember. Then we have used it 7805. Then on the negative side, we have used 7912 and 7905. So the voltage regulator over here, and ultimately we will have a DC output voltage at the end. So the DC output voltage will be a regulated one, and it is going to give you a constant voltage on that. So believe me, friends, this is going to be a very interesting for you people to understand how the circuit, the DC power supply that we have made, is how it's going to work really. So this is how I will repeat it for again for you people. So initially we are having the plug where we are putting it to a 230 volt AC, and then the input is given to the transformer, which is actually a step down transformer. There are two types of transformers, step up transformer and a step down transformer. Then the output, which is of the transformer, which is supposed to be the lower AC voltage, that is say in our case we have used a 12-12 transformer, which implies that it is going to give you 0 to 12 or 12 volts. So 12 volts we have got over here from 230 volt AC to we have got 12 volts. Now this 12 volts is given to a rectifier circuit. This rectifier is going to convert AC into a DC. Still, I have told you that this DC is still not a pure DC, but it is a pulsating DC. P-U-L-S-A-T-I-N-G, pulsating DC. It is called as a pulsating DC. So it gives you a pulsating DC. Since it is not pure, then it has to be given to a filter circuit to make it at a constant or a pure DC. Then a filter may be any of type, LCs, capacitor. We are going to study those filters also in this chapter. So filters are there, which will now after that, the output will be a pure DC. In our case, we have used, say, the capacitor of 1000 microfarad in our practical, in our circuit. So this was that. And then after that, we might be requiring a voltage regulator as per your requirements. So voltage regulators are different types of ICs that we can use. And after that, we are expecting our DC signal, DC output voltage to come across this. Now, let us start with this block that is called as a rectifier. As I told you, the rectifiers are of three types, the half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier, and the bridge rectifier. So we are going to study one by one. So there are three types of rectifiers. One is called as the half wave rectifier. The other one is called as the full wave rectifier. And the last one, the third one, is going to called as the bridge rectifier that we have earlier studied. So the bridge rectifier circuit is we have designed that circuit in our short term course that is called as printed circuit board design and implementation circuit. So I hope these are not new, but for that you should understand the basic working of a simple diode, PN junction diode. So for that, just to recall it, we will go for an say half wave rectifier circuit. So in half wave rectification, what it is called as a half wave, why it is called as a half wave rectifier? Now if you remember in our previous slides, like this one, so here we are having a sine wave. This is a positive half cycle and a negative half cycle. So we are having two half. One is in the positive side and the other one is in the negative side. So these two combined will give you a full wave. And if we are rectifying only half of this signal, then it is called as a half wave rectifier. I will show you this. So these are that. So in half wave rectification, only half of the wave, either positive or negative, is rectified or passed, while the other half is blocked. And therefore, it is called as a half wave rectifier. Usually, when I teach offline, then I don't show you, I don't define the half wave rectifier, but I teach you first and then I tell you that why it is called as a half wave rectifier. So, because only one half of the input waveform reaches the output, it is very inefficient. This circuit has a drawback, that it has it is very inefficient because only half of the cycle is being passed forward and the other half is being blocked. So the maximum power is not being used, half of the power is being reduced. So this is the half wave rectifier. Now to start with this, this is actually, if you recall this, I hope we have studied this as a PN junction diode and the forward characteristics of a PN junction diode, as I told you. So PN junction diode, how it works, if you recall it, then we say like that, whenever a positive terminal of battery is connected to p-type and a negative terminal of a battery is connected to n-type, then what happens? Due to the positive potential in the p-type and negative potential in the n-type, the positive holes are being repelled by the positive polarity of the battery, and negative electrons are being repelled by that, and due to which the depletion layer will go on decreasing. And as soon as the voltage increases the 0.7 volt, the depletion layer dissolves and the diode starts conducting in forward bias directions, right? So this was how the diode works in forward bias condition. Whenever the p-type terminal is connected to positive and n-type of the diode is connected to negative terminal of the battery, then the diode is said to be forward bias. But yes, it requires normally 0.7 volt to be forward bias, not less than that. 0.7 volt it requires to be forward less. Next, if the polarity is being reversed, that is, if a p-type terminal is connected to n-type and if a n-type is connected to the p terminal of the battery, then what it happens? It happens like both are being attracted towards the polarity, and in the context, the depletion layer will go on increasing, right? So as a effect, the diode does not conduct in reverse bias. Yes, so that basic concept is being used over here in the half wave rectifier. The diode is connected to the transformer. So if I got the circuit, then I might have shown you that this AC signal, how it shifts. So a positive half comes over here at the point A, and at point B there is a negative half cycle. That is how it is being shown. So the positive half is on the A side and negative half is at the B side, B point. Am I able to are you able to view this slide?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, right. So are you able to view this A point and B point? So AC means when this point A is at positive half cycle, B is at more negative half cycle. So at both these points, we are having a reverse signal. So this is at positive half cycle and this is at negative half cycle. So what it implies is, if A is at positive, that means the anode of this diode is at positive, and at B is negative means the cathode is at negative. So this diode ultimately is in forward bias condition, and the diode is going to work in this forward bias. Whereas during the second half cycle, that is the negative half cycle, remember these words, during the second half or the second negative half cycle, the A is at negative half and B is at more positive. So since anode is at negative and cathode is at positive, the diode is now reverse bias. This is what we are expecting you to write in your exam. These are some of the 4 points, and due to which the diode does not conduct in the negative half cycle. So when I am talking about the positive half cycle, I have to write two paragraphs. The first paragraph I am going to write like this: during the first positive half cycle, the point A is at positive potential and point B is at negative potential. Means, second point in paragraph one, that anode of the diode is at positive potential and cathode is at negative potential. When this situation is there, the diode is forward biased and the diode conducts. So the half wave, the half positive half cycle is being rectified and the output is taken across this load resistance RL. So the circuit is being complete. During the negative half cycle, what happens? The point A is at negative potential and point B is at positive potential, which implies that anode is at negative half cycle, negative, and cathode is at more positive. So the diode is in reverse bias and the diode does not conduct. So the other half, that is the negative half cycle, is been blocked by this diode, and only half of the cycle is being rectified. So this was the working of that. Construction is simple. You can write like this. The AC supply is given to the primary P1 and P2 of the transformer. The S1 and S2 is connected to the diode and the anode of diode, and the cathode is connected to the S2 terminal, so that through the load RL, this is how this construction will look like. And the output voltage is taken across the load resistance RL. So this is like this. So the flow you can show like this: A, then the diode D, then load resistance RL, then B, and again A. So the circuit is complete. So half of the cycle has been rectified. In the reverse half cycle, the diode is reverse bias, so it does not conduct, and therefore it blocks that negative half cycle. Now, if I would like to show you one animation of that. So this is like this. So this is half wave rectifier working circuit. So this is that half cycle which I was talking about. So the first half cycle, during the first half cycle, it works. So the diode conducts during the first half cycle. So half of the cycle is being output over here. And in the second half cycle, again, when it is positive, then the other half is also coming. So see, the flow of electron is also being shown over there, and the other is there. So this is how the half wave rectifier circuit works. See again. So this is the first positive half cycle coming over there. During this positive half cycle, the diode is forward biased and it is working. During the negative half cycle, the diode is reverse biased. This is the negative half cycle, and the output is not there, not over there, because it is not working. Again, during the next positive half cycle, it will work and the output will come across the load resistance area. That is how this circuit rectifies only half of the cycle, and the negative half cycle is being blocked, and therefore this circuit is called as a half wave rectifier circuit, because it's going to rectify only half of the half wave of the full sinusoidal wave. So I hope you have got this. So this is the first half and this is the second half. So during the negative half cycle, which is in the downward direction, the diode is reverse biased and it does not work. So only positive half cycle, during the positive half cycle, it works, and the other during the other cycle, it does not work. So the diode, this is the half wave rectifier circuit, and this is actually the animation during which slightly shows that how a diode conducts. Now the arrow shows that it is the electrons, the flow of electrons is in the reverse direction, right? The current is in the forward direction. So always the flow of electrons is opposite to the flow of current or the flow of the charges. So that is being shown over here in the diagram. If you are able to see the arrows are in the reverse direction, which implies that the electrons are flowing in that direction. The current is flowing in the forward direction, the arrow of the diode. So these are the electrons that are being shown over here, which are showing that the diode is conducting during the positive half cycle, and during the negative half cycle, the diode is not conducting. So this is there. So there is a limitation of time. So I hope you have got this half wave rectifier circuit. Again, I'm revising what we have studied today. So this is that we have studied. We have started with here. We are going to study half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier, bridge rectifier. Then this was the introduction of rectifier. Rectifier is defined as a circuit which converts AC signal into a DC signal, that is called as a rectifier. Then this was the block diagram of DC power supply, the total block diagram. These are the contents which are required for a regulated DC power supply. Means we are having the AC power supply coming at our homes, and we have to rectify it, and then only it is going to be converted into DC, and then only we are able to use it for our electronic devices like TVs and the other devices. So we require DC power supply for them, and for that the power supply is a very crucial and important portion of any of the electronic device. So that is why we are studying this. And this DC block diagram, in this DC block diagram, I have shown you that this is the plug where we are putting it into a 230 volt AC and having a 50 hertz of frequency. This is a transformer which is going to lower the amplitude of this AC voltage to a low value, that is say might be 12 volts, and then it is given to a rectifier circuit. Remember, transformer does not conduct AC into DC. It just lowers a higher AC to lower AC or vice versa, depending on the type of transformer. So transformer just converts or lowers the higher AC to a lower AC, that's all. Only rectifier converts AC into DC. Remember this. So many of the times whenever we go for a Viva and ask them, which device converts AC into DC? Most of the students say like the transformer converts AC into DC. Transformer does not converts AC into DC. It just lowers the amplitude of a higher AC signal to a lower AC signal, and that's all, nothing more than that. So this was that. Then it is given to a rectifier circuit. The waveforms are shown on the top. I hope you might be taking the screenshot so that if any time you require this, you are able to recall it. Still, I'm going to put it on YouTube also. So I'll be sharing a link with you and you can view that anytime. So that is there. So rectifier is over there. This is the signal that we are having at the output of the rectifier, which is again not a pure DC. It is called as a pulsating DC. PULSATING, pulsating DC. So that is over there. Then the pulsating DC is given to a filter, and after the output of the filter is now a pure DC over here. So this is over there, and this is if you require a voltage regulated circuit, regulated power supply, then we will put it to regulated IC. In our case, we have used it like 7812 and 789, 7805, 7912 and 7905. Then we will have a DC regulated supply. Lastly, I have told you about the types of rectifiers. We are having three types of rectifiers. So half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier and a bridge rectifier. Then we have studied about the half wave rectifier. In half wave rectifier, we are converting only half of the cycle. We are rectifying only half of the cycle, might be positive half cycle or a negative half cycle, and the other half cycle is being blocked. So that is why it is called as half wave rectifier. The circuit is like this. AC signal is given to the primary of a transformer. The secondary, this is A or S1, is connected to diode, the anode of the diode D, and the cathode of diode is connected to the secondary S2 through load resistance RL. This is the construction. The output is taken across the load resistance RL. Then this is the working of that. During the positive half cycle, the diode is forward bias and the diode conducts. During the negative half cycle, the diode remains reverse bias and therefore it does not conduct, and only half of the wave is being rectified. So here only positive half cycle is rectified and the negative half cycle has been blocked. So this is all about the half wave rectifier. In the next class, we will be studying the next, the other rectifiers. So by now I'm stopping the share. So this is over there. So I'll just take your attendance. If you have any queries, I will feel free to ask. I'll be happy to resolve your difficulties. If you have any queries,
sir, in the half wave rectifier, right, there would be a loss of power, and even the output produced will be the output voltage will be also low in the half wave rectifier.
Yes, definitely. That's what I've said, that comparatively with respect to the other rectifiers, half wave rectifier is inefficient in power because it is losing half of the power, right? So make sure that this half wave rectifier we are not using in the regulated circuits also. We are just using it for some devices where we don't require much regulated or much voltage, right? But it is, yes, obviously it's going to lose much of the power because we are misusing a half of the wave, no?
Yes.
Hai na? So yes. This rectifier is not used more oftenly. So that is why it is inefficient also, right? So this is all there, yes, definitely. So any other questions if you have, you can ask. Right, I hope you got. So if you have any queries about, say...
Hello? सर आपने जो ब्लॉक डायग्राम बताए थे डीसी पावर सप्लाई की
राइट
उसमें रेक्टिफायर से पल्सेटिंग डीसी निकल रही है आउटपुट में
राइट बरोबर
तो सर पल्सेटिंग डीसी निकल रही है प्योर क्यों नहीं निकल सकती
प्योर इसलिए नहीं निकलते कि हमने अभी देखा ना कि हाफ वेव पूरी की पूरी पल्स आती है वहां पर है ना कैसी आती है एक पल्स आती है ना तो ये प्योर है क्या प्योर कैसे होनी चाहिए लाइन होनी चाहिए सीधी लाइन स्ट्रेट लाइन होनी चाहिए बराबर है
okay.
ना हमारे को तो एक आधी पल्स मिल रही है इसको प्योर करने के लिए फिर हम लोग क्या लगाते हैं वहां पर फिल्टर का सर्किट लगाते हैं तो फिल्टर के लिए हम लोगों ने अपने सर्किट में क्या यूज किया था 1000 माइक्रो फैरेड का कैपेसिटर लिया हमारे पास अलग अलग प्रकार के फिल्टर होते हैं जो ये पल्सेटिंग डीसी को प्योर डीसी में कन्वर्ट करते हाँ बट ये कैसे कर रहा है एक साइड में ये हमारे को एक पूरे साइकल्स दे रहे हैं अभी देखना फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर में आधी आधी साइकल्स करके हम लोग उसका पूरा वेव बनाएंगे है ना उसके बाद हम लोग उसको यूज करेंगे राइट समझा ना
ओके थैंक यू सर
ठीक है हाँ हाँ मैं कल फिर से इसको रिपीट करेंगे हम लोग तब उसको पूछेंगे अभी नाउ वी आर रनिंग शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम सो आई विल बी एंडिंग दिस मीटिंग राइट नाउ एंड वी विल बी टॉकिंग ऑन इट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास राइट थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर जॉइनिंग कीप इन टच एंड इफ यू हैव एनी क्यूरीज फील फ्री टू आस्क डोंट शाय राइट We'll be continuing it tomorrow also. Thank you. And I will be uploading this video on YouTube also. I will be sharing this link also. Thank you. Good day. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Say bye. Bye.